One wonders what life must have been like in the 20s and 30s if you were one of the famous Bentley boys, dashing men who lived life to the full, drank hard and raced hard at famous circuits all over Europe. Right through the decades, the factory at Crewe have produced some truly memorable cars. How about this one? A 1956 Bentley Continental S1 Fastback, which, if you're interested, is for sale at this dealership in Cheshire, price around £45,000. It's absolutely immaculate. It stands the test of time even today. But if you want a Bentley today, the car to buy is this, the new Arnage Saloon. But is it good enough to take on the world's best and transport Bentley into the new millennium? The Arnage and the Silver Seraph, both launched in 1998, were styled by Graham Hull. It's an all-new body shell over the previous Royles and Bentley models, with greater torsional rigidity, giving improved aerodynamics and fuel efficiency. It has a very sleek appearance, certainly when compared to the previous model anyway, with flowing lines. It sits fairly low on the road and has a drag coefficient of 0.37, a 12% improvement on the old model. Now, the Arnage and the Silver Seraph are basically the same shape, apart from with the Bentley you get a few extra spoilers. And it's a shape that has grown on me tremendously since I've had this car. And of course, the Bentley has this wonderful, wonderful distinctive mesh grille. But under the bonnet is what you want to know about. And this is where you get the 4.5 litre all aluminium engine from BMW. Now, it's basically the same engine that's in the 740. Thank goodness it's been worked on, it's been modified. It now has twin water-cooled turbochargers. It pumps out 350 brake horsepower, 413 pounds-foot of torque, which makes it very, very fast. It's just a shame that when you flip the lid and you look at the engine, it's not a hand-built engine anymore. Now, as you would expect, stepping into a Bentley is an experience all in itself, with this gorgeous, finest Connolly leather, the wood, the chrome, the thick Wilton carpets that your feet almost get lost in. It's like spending a day in a gentleman's club. These gorgeous cream dials, the chrome, the wood, the leather, it makes you realise the amount of work that's gone into producing this car. And what about back here? Well, as you would imagine, it's very, very comfortable. However, there's not the room that there used to be in the rear of a Bentley. Anyone over about 6 foot tall might have a bit of difficulty getting themselves comfortable. Your knees tend to be fairly high and you sit quite low. Apart from that, there are wonderful, wonderful electric seats here. And as for this, gorgeous picnic tables, ideal for strawberries and cream at Henley this summer. There are a lot worse places to be than the back of here, that's for sure. A big fat cigar and a dry martini would go down very well right now.
It will be very interesting to see how Volkswagen develop the Bentley brand, as they will certainly have to do after paying so much money for it. The range currently consists of the Arnage and four variants of the coupe, the soft top Azure, Continental R and T, and the newest arrival, the Sedanka SC, which you may have seen Ken Gibson driving recently on Motor Week. Baby Bentleys, updated coupes, who knows what we'll see in the future.
Power to the rear wheels of the Arnage is handled superbly by a 5-speed automatic ZF gearbox, which has two modes, normal and sport. If you fancy a blast down country lanes, well, flick it into sport mode, and the ultra-fast kickdown will have you rocketing towards the horizon so fast you'll hardly have time to catch your breath. It really is an astonishingly quick car.
The growl you hear from the engine under normal driving becomes a full-blooded roar once you open the Arnage up. The throttle is light and crisp. There's no discernible turbo lag. One criticism of the car, though, is the amount of wind noise that comes into the cabin when cruising on the motorway, particularly here around the A-pillars. The brakes are superb thanks to a new power boost brake system with four-channel ABS and micro-alloy discs too. The ride is slightly firm, the handling is good, and the steering just nicely weighted to give the right amount of feedback.
0 to 60 comes up in 6.2 seconds, which for such a big car is still astonishing. Top speed has been limited to a mere 150 miles per hour. Gone are the days when the company wouldn't release power and performance figures, describing them as merely adequate. Now they want to sing them from the rooftops. The old phrase about if you have to ask how many miles to the gallon it does, you can't afford it. Well, I suppose it's still relevant. But even if I could afford this car, I'd like to know how many miles it does do to a gallon or a tank. Are you sitting down? Well, 12 miles per gallon urban, 16 combined, with a tank that takes nearly 21 gallons. It'll set you back well over £60 to fill up. Still, most Bentley owners have about four other cars in the garage, so I guess they can afford it.
Despite its huge size, it's surprisingly easy to hustle this car fast down country lanes. The grip and the cornering are tremendous, and the power just keeps coming and coming. Mind you, this is one car I wouldn't like to take down a narrow country lane. Meet something coming the other way, and it's doubtful if the driver will doff his cap and offer to move out of the way for you, Governor. So, is the Arnage a good car? Certainly. Is it a great car? Possibly. Is it a car that's worthy of the Bentley mark? Absolutely. But can you say it's worth the £145,000 purchase price that this will cost you? Well, that has to be subjective. If this is just another car in your fleet, well, you probably hardly notice the dent in your bank balance it would take to buy this car. A new S-Class is half the price of the Arnage, for instance. You could probably buy a row of terraced houses in some parts of the country, but an ocean-going yacht is considerably more expensive than this. And that's the sort of context that you have to take with cars that cost this amount of money. Is it to be another rare masterpiece to hang on the walls of your mansion, or a Bentley Arnage? There's only one answer for me, and it's this. It may not be the best car in the world, but it certainly beats staring at a picture.